Alright, we have a Watts 2-inch LF007 M1 QT. Serial number 081406. This is a double check valve. Our incoming water comes from the bottom. This is test port 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this is a hose bib. It's after the containment device. It used to be there. That's capped off, and there's no other illegal connections before the containment device. Let's hook up test ports 3 and 4 with the adapters, and then we'll use the TK9A to test. All right, let's open up. Sorry, let's close shutoff valve number 2. Let's close the valves on the test kit. Let's open up test port number 3. I gotta tighten that up a little bit. Let's purge the air from pipe test port hose through A, closing B. Needle stays pegged on high side of test gauge. Let's close shutoff valve number 1. Needle stays pegged. Let's open up B and drop our needle to 2 PSID. Oh, it's jumping back up. That means shutoff valve number 1 is not closed. Sure does seem closed to me. I know we had some debris stuck in there. And now we're gonna open up test port number 2. And it stayed above 1 PSID. So check valve number 1 passed. Let's take the hose, put it on 4. Let's open the shutoff valve number 1. Close those. Let's open up test port number 4. Okay. Let's bleed the air through A and B. Close B. Close shutoff valve number 1. Stays pegged in the high side. Made note of line pressure, which is 50 PSI. Let's drop this to 2 PSID. It's still climbing up. We have something going on with that check valve right there. Okay, 2 PSID. Let's open up test port number 3. Needle stayed above 1 PSID. Check valve number 2 passed. We'll make note of this valve acting up